No dejes que ningún hombre quite esa corona.
That's what I'm going to preach to you about today.
Es lo
Amen.
Que voy a predicar
All
esta
right.
mañana.
You going to preach with me?
¿Vas a predicar right. conmigo?
Amen. You may be seated.
Puedes tomar tu asiento.
God bless you. When Saul
Cuando Saúl
became the king of Israel,
vino a ser el rey de Israel,
Israel was in a state of intimidation. They were servants to the Philistines.
Israel estaba intimidado por los filisteos.
And in fact, the Philistine armies
y los del ejército
had established some military outposts right in the land of Israel.
Habían puesto unas bases allí en la tierra de Israel.
So these were the enemies of the people of God.
So estos eran enemigos de la gente de Dios.
And they had forts where they had a lot of swords and soldiers, right in the land, in God's land, these enemies, they had forts right there.
Y tenían grupos ahí armados con espadas esperando ahí mismo en el territorio de Israel.
So it appears that Saul made up his mind as king that he was going to drive these out.
Pero Saúl tenía que poner su mente que tenía que sacar a estos para afuera.
But he didn't want to start with an all-out war against the whole nation. He just decided to start, you know, one little fort at a time.
Él no quería hacer toda la guerra grande, sino que quería hacer una parte primeramente.
So he got about 3,000 soldiers together.
So tenía 3,000 soldados juntos.
Sent the rest of them all home.
Y los demás los mandó para la casa.
It wasn't a big battle.
No era una gran guerra.
He thought.
Él pensaba. Yeah.
And so he got about 2,000 soldiers for him and about 1,000 soldiers for his son Jonathan.
Él tenía 2,000 soldados para él y 1,000 soldados para su hijo Jonathan.
And so they started in on
para
the war.
Que comenzaran la guerra.
Now I want you to read with me several I just use that as an introduction, but I want you to read. We're going to read the story from the Bible, 1 Samuel 13.
Vamos a leer la historia en la Biblia del 1 Samuel, verso capítulo 13.
13, verse 1.
El capítulo 13 en el verso 1.
And you'll have to look in your Bibles if with me today, if you will, because our PowerPoint is not working. Sí. We're going to get a new PowerPoint, but today let's get our Bibles out and that'll work fine.
Tienes que leer en tu Biblia porque no trabaja ahora el sistema y pues vamos a leer en la Biblia ahora.
Amen. 1 Samuel 13.
Primera de Samuel 13.
Okay, now we're not going to read this we're not going to read it two times. I think no. You have some Bibles?
No.
You have some Spanish Bibles?
Traen Biblias en
Sister
español.
Odelia, you have your Bible? Okay, good. Brother Raul, okay, here we go. 1 Samuel 13:1. I'm just going to read it in English, and then after we're through reading these scriptures, then Brother Lima's going to translate for me into Spanish, but... And I don't have a long sermon.
Vamos a leer todo en la Biblia y después hermano Lima va a traducir todo lo demás.
And you're thinking, right, we've heard that before.
Y tú sabes que el sermón digo que está corto, pero tú ya lo conoces, que tal vez no sé si va a estar
it's
corto.
It's going to be short. Amen.
Que va a estar corto.
Are you with me? Praise God.
¿Estás
Amen.
Conmigo?
Is the Lord good?
Yes.
Amen.
¿El Señor es bueno?
Hallelujah. 1 Samuel 13:1. Saul reigned 1 year, and when he had reigned 2 years over Israel, Saul chose him 3,000 men of Israel, whereof 2,000 were with Saul in Michmash and in Mount Bethel, and 1,000 were with Jonathan in Gibeah of Benjamin. And the rest of the people he sent, every man to his tent. And Jonathan smote the garrison of the Philistines, or the fort, that was in Geba, and the Philistines heard of it. The word started to get around. And Saul blew the trumpet throughout all the land, saying, Let the Hebrews hear, And all Israel heard say that Saul had smitten the garrison of the Philistines, and that Israel also was had in abomination with the Philistines, and the people were called together after Saul to Gilgal. So war was started.
Entonces la guerra iba a comenzar.
And the Philistines gathered themselves together to fight with Israel. 30,000 chariots and 6,000 horsemen and people as the sand which is on the seashore in multitude. And they came up and pitched in Michmash eastward from Bethaven. And when the men of Israel saw that they were in a strait, they were in trouble, for the people were distressed, then the people of Israel hid themselves in caves and in thickets and in rocks and in high places and in pits. And some of the Hebrews went over Jordan to the land of Gad and Gilead. So they were very afraid. They were running. And as for Saul, he was yet in Gilgal, and all the people following him trembling. And he tarried 7 days, according to the set time that Samuel had appointed. But Samuel came not to Gilgal, and the people were scattered from him. And Saul said, "Bring hither a burnt offering to me and peace offerings." And he offered the burnt offering. And it came to pass that as soon as he had made an end of offering the burnt offering, behold, Samuel came. And Saul went out to meet him that he might salute him. And Samuel said, "What hast thou done?" And Saul said, "Because I saw the people were scattered from me, and that thou camest not within the days appointed, and that the Philistines gathered themselves together at Michmash, therefore, said I, the Philistines will come down now upon me to Gilgal, and I have not made supplication to the Lord. I forced myself, therefore, and offered a burnt offering." He had a lot of excuses.
Tenía muchas excusas.
And Samuel said to Saul, "Thou hast done foolishly. Thou hast not kept the commandment of the Lord, thy God, which he commanded thee. For now would the Lord have established thy kingdom upon Israel forever. But now thy kingdom shall not continue. The Lord hath sought him a man, another man, after his own heart. And the Lord hath commanded him to be captain over his people, because thou hast not kept that which the Lord commanded thee." Amen. So now we're going to turn to the New Testament, if you would bear with me, for some long scripture readings this morning.
Ahora vamos al Nuevo Testamento para otra escritura.
This was right after Jesus had ascended into heaven.
Esto era después que Jesús subió al cielo.
All the disciples were gathered together in Jerusalem.
Todos los discípulos estaban juntos en Jerusalén.
They were waiting for the power of the Holy Ghost to come.
Estaban esperando ellos por el Espíritu Santo que viniera.
And so they had a business meeting. They had to take care of some business.
Ellos tenían una junta de negocios.
This is the book of Acts.
Este es el libro de Hechos.
Chapter 1, verse 15.
El capítulo 1, el verso 15.
All right, if you found the place, say amen.
Si encontraste, right. Puedes decir un amén.
And in those days, Peter stood up in the midst of the disciples and said, the number of names together were about 120. And this is what Peter said: "Men and brethren, this scripture must needs have been fulfilled, which the Holy Ghost by the mouth of David spake before concerning Judas, which was to guide them that took Jesus." So, Peter told them,
Pedro les dijo a ellos,
"We've got to take care of some business because the scripture said,
tenemos que tomar estos negocios porque la Biblia dice,
that Judas was going to betray the Lord,
que Judas iba a a traicionar a Jesús.
All right. Verse 17 said, "For he was numbered with us and had obtained a part of this ministry." So Judas, he went astray.
Judas fue.
But he was a part of the ministry at one time. He was one of the apostles.
Él no era parte de era parte de los
okay.
Discípulos.
Okay, I'm going to read now several verses. Now, Peter is telling the story of what happened to Judas.
Ahora Pedro estaba diciendo qué es lo que pasaba a Judas.
Okay, now this man Judas. Let me just read this part. I think you have your Bible, so let me just read this. Now, this is verse 18. Now, this man, he's talking about Judas, purchased a field with the reward of iniquity. You remember that 30 pieces of silver? He bought a field with that. And falling headlong, he burst asunder in the midst, and all his bowels gushed out. And it was known to all the dwellers at Jerusalem, inasmuch as that field is called in their proper tongue, Aceldama, that is the field of blood. So Peter explained what happened to Judas.
Pedro estaba explicando todo lo que pasó a Judas.
And then he goes back and quotes the prophecy from the Old Testament about this situation.
Y fue a decir de lo que iba a pasar de lo que decía antes la profecía.
Verse 20. For it is written in the book of Psalms. Verse 20.
El verso 20.
How we doing? Everybody say a team effort. All right. For it is written in the book of Psalms. Now he's quoting. Let his habitation be desolate. Whose habitation are we talking about? Judas, okay. Let his habitation be desolate, and let no man dwell therein, and his bishopric let another take, or his office. Okay, are you with me this morning?
¿Estás conmigo esta mañana?
Judas was one of the 12 apostles.
Judas era uno de los 12 apóstoles.
But the Old Testament said somebody else is going to take his job.
Pero el viejo testimonio decía que alguien iba a tomar su trabajo.
So they had a business meeting.
Por eso tenía una junta de negocio.
Verse 21.
El verso 21.
Wherefore of these men which is accompanied with us all the time that the Lord Jesus went in and out among us, beginning from the baptism of John unto the same day that he was taken up from us, must one be ordained to be a witness with us of his resurrection. And they appointed two, Joseph called Barsabbas, who was surnamed Justus, and Matthias. And they prayed and said, Thou Lord, which knowest the hearts of all men, show whether of these two thou hast chosen, that he may take part of this ministry and apostleship from which Judas by transgression fell, that he might go to his own place. And they gave forth their lots, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was numbered with the 11 apostles. So Judas was replaced by Matthias.
Judas estaba reemplazado por Judas.
One more passage.
Matthias.
Revelation chapter 3.
Revelación capítulo 3.
Verse 7.
Verso 7.
And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, These things saith he that is holy, he that is true, he that hath the key of David, he that openeth and no man shutteth, and shutteth, and no man openeth. I know thy works. This is Revelation 3:8.
Este es Revelación 3:8.
I know thy works. Behold, I have set before thee an open door, and no man can shut it. For thou hast a little strength, and hast kept my word, and hast not denied my name. Behold,